हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ELS इंग्लिश लिटरेचर स्टडीज विद कोर हरप्रीत। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट जैकोबियन एंड कैरोलिन ड्रामा। एंड इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट जैकोबियन पीरियड एंड कैरोलिन पीरियड। जैकोबियन पीरियड इज फ्रॉम 1603 टू 1625, देन कैरोलिन पीरियड फॉल्स बिटवीन 1625 टू 1642। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ और ग्रोथ ऑफ ड्रामा ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड। Actually, after Shakespeare, the drama suffered a decline in England, and that is during the reigns of James I and Charles I respectively. The real spirit of the Elizabethan drama, which reached its height during the time of Shakespeare, that disappeared, and later dramatists called as Dickens can't continue the same spirit of drama. At this time, sentiments replaced character, revelation of fine shades of characters became important in themselves, and we can also say dreadful deeds now left rhetorical effect on the audience. These deeds which are used by Shakespeare to throw light on the working of human heart and mind, now these produced rhetorical effects on the audience. And unlike Shakespeare and other dramatists, the Jacobean and Caroline dramatists emphasized passive suffering, and these dramatists showed no delight in action. Pathos and woe were the main characteristics of their heroes. They left behind courage and stern qualities, and when we go through Elizabethan prose, sometimes we perceive their prose is coarse, harsh, but these later dramatists were deliberately indecent. They used prose as a weapon to exercise their own power. Right, and thus in the hands of these dramatists, drama suffered a decline and it died its natural death when the Puritans closed the theatres in 1642 under Oliver Cromwell, and it was no more same romantic drama it was, as we can say, it was during Elizabethan period. And the greatest dramatist of the Jacobean period was Ben Jonson. He was also known as Rear Ben, who wrote poetry, prose and drama. He occupies the second place among English dramatists of the reign of Elizabethan I and James I. He is called as Rear Ben, as he was master of, we can say, theatrical plot, master of language and characterization. His best known plays are Volpone and The Alchemist. And Volpone, The Alchemist, Bartholomew Fair especially have been staged with striking success. And it is Jonson who exerted a great influence on the playwrights who immediately followed him. In late Jacobean and Caroline years, literature, it was Beaumont and Fletcher who provided all the models, but it is one and only one Ben Jonson who gave the essential impulse to dramatize the characterization, or who laid emphasis on dramatic characterization in the comedy of the Restoration and also in 18th and 19th century. It is Jonson who influenced later on younger Jacobean and Caroline playwrights and poets. The other dramatists of the Jacobean and Caroline periods are John Marston, Thomas Dacre, Thomas Heywood, Thomas Middleton, John Webster, John Fletcher, Francis Beaumont, and John Ford and James Shirley. John Marston wrote in a violent and extravagant style. His melodramas are full of forceful and impressive passages, and his best play is Eastward Ho, which portrays realistically the life of a tradesman. Thomas Dacre, unlike Marston, was gentle and free from coarseness and cynicism. Some of his plays possess great freshness, which we can't find even in the plays of Jonson, also Ben Jonson's plays. Thomas Dacre is more of a popular dramatist than any of his contemporaries, and he is at his best when he portrays scenes from life, and also at his best when he describes people with an irresistible touch of romanticism. Next is John Webster, who wrote a number of plays, some were written in collaboration, and his well-known are The White Devil and The Duchess of Malfi. The Duchess of Malfi is a tragedy of the young widowed Duchess, who is driven to madness and death by her two brothers because she married her steward Antonio. And this play is full of pathos, and it also has touches of fine poetry. Next is John Ford, who was a true melancholic and gloomy person. His famous work is It's Pity She's a Whore. And John Ford occupies a high place as an artist. James Shirley, whom Charles Lamb called as the last of a great race, his works show no originality. He continued the tradition which was formed by Fletcher and Webster. Besides these, there are a number of minor dramatists, but the dramas suffered a serious setback when the theatres were closed by the Puritans, and they were opened only after 18 years later at the Restoration. So friends, this is all about today's topic. I hope you will like it, and if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel, and if you're new on my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.